Hello everybody, once again I am back with my video lecture. Today I am going to teach about the drainage of India. Now before I start my teaching, I have one request that if you like my video and the presentation, please don't forget to subscribe my channel, because if you subscribe my channel, definitely you are going to get the notification whenever I upload any educative or informative video in my YouTube channel. The Indian rivers. India is blessed with hundreds of large and small rivers. That means there are many rivers in different parts of our country. They are an important natural resources and form the lifeline of the Indian masses. These rivers are an important natural resources. Why? Because we use the river water for the purpose of irrigation, transporting goods from one place to another, and also for generating hydroelectricity. The drainage pattern of India is influenced by the nature of landforms. We have already read about it in the chapter called The Relief of India, where you have seen that India is made up of different types of landform like plateau, plain and mountain. All these landforms have their influence upon the drainage pattern in our country or the rivers in our country. The Himalayan river systems. We broadly classify the Himalayan river systems into three categories. Number one, the Indus river systems. Number two, the Ganga river system. And number three, the Brahmaputra river system. These three river systems mainly occupy the northern Indian plain. Indus river system is made up of river Indus and its five tributaries: Jhelum, Chenab, Ravi, Bias and Satluj. Ganga river is made up of large number of tributaries. Some of the tributaries have their origin in Himalayan mountain range, and some of the tributaries have their origin in peninsular plateau. Those tributaries that have their origin in peninsular plateau are also considered as a part of peninsular river system. And Brahmaputra is also made up of small number of tributaries like Dhansiri, Barak, Subansiri, etc. The peninsular river. We can broadly classify the peninsular river into two categories: river flowing into Bay of Bengal known as East Flowing River. Example, Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri. On the other side, river flowing into Arabian Sea are known as West Flowing River. Example, Narmada and Tapi. Only the East Flowing River follows the general slope of the landform, that is from west to east. Now I will discuss in detail about the differences between the Himalayan rivers and the peninsular rivers. Himalayan rivers are example of antecedent drainage, because this river maintained their original flow direction and the course despite change in the landform. You can understand this concept better if you go through this diagram. Initially, there is a stream flowing on horizontal sedimentary rocks. Now, these horizontal sedimentary rocks have undergone upliftment due to folding or compression that result in the formation of a ridge. Despite there is a ridge in the flow path of the river maintains its course by cutting this ridge, by cutting a steep walled gorge in this ridge. Now, why we called peninsular rivers as an example of consequent drainage? Because peninsular rivers follow the general slope of the land. Most of the peninsular river except Narmada and Tapi follow the general slope of the land that I have said from west to east. Difference on the basis of basin area. The North Indian River or the Himalayan rivers have large basin area. On the other hand, the peninsular river have small basin area. This I have explained with the help of two river system. You can see in this diagram that river Ganga have large basin and catchment area in comparison to river Godavari. Why? Because Ganga have large number of tributaries, whereas Godavari have small number of tributaries. You can understand this concept better if you go through this basin map of India, river basin map of India. Here you will find that in comparison to major North Indian rivers like Ganga and Indus, there are many rivers in peninsular plateau in South India that have very small basin, like Narmada, Tapi, Krishna, Kaveri, etc. So this diagram also help us to understand that the basin area and the catchment area of the North Indian rivers are larger than the basin area and catchment area of the South Indian river or the peninsular river. Differences on the basis of source of rivers. Most of the North Indian rivers or the Himalayan rivers are snow-fed. Why they are called snow-fed? Because they have their origin from the glaciers of mountain. The glaciers of mountain melt and provide water to these rivers. On the other hand, the peninsular rivers have their source from waterfall. And also they get a good amount of water from rainfall. So we often call the peninsular rivers as rain-fed rivers. Now I will discuss in detail about Indo-Brahman theory, the theory that describes the origin of three major river system of North India or the three major Himalayan river system. If you see in this diagram, you will find that flow direction of the Shivalik river or Indo-Brahman river have been shown. This river is flowing from Assam to Gulf of Sindh during Miocene period. Now, why this river is called Shivalik river? Because it was believed by the geologist that the Shivalik range of Himalayan mountain system have been formed due to deposition of the sediment brought down by Indo-Brahman river. So after the name of Shivalik mountain range, we call it also as Shivalik river. Now later what happened, this mighty river got subdivided into three major North Indian river system or the Himalayan river system, that is Indus river system, Ganga river system and Brahmaputra river system. Now Indus river system, as I have said you, it composed of five tributaries. Ganga have many tributaries and Brahmaputra have small amount of tributaries. Now, why this bifurcation happened? Why the division of Indo-Brahm or Shivalik river happens? It happens due to upheaval in the western Himalayas, including the Kotwar plateau in the Pleistocene age. And it also happened due to headward erosion by the tributaries of the Indo-Brahma river. Now, this theory have been criticized on the following ground. Number one, the Shivalik range can also be formed due to the deposition of sediment brought down by the rivers flowing down the slope of the Himalayas. We not have to imagine a mighty river like Indo-Brahma to describe the formation of Shivalik range. It can also happen due to deposition of sediment brought down by the rivers flowing down the slope of the Himalayas. The evidence of Tipam sandstone of Assam, which were deposited in estuary, also speak against that theory, because the mighty Indo-Brahma river have its source in Assam. So it is next to impossible to see Tipam sandstone appearing in the place where a river is originating, because Tipam sandstone normally appear in estuary, that means a place where river meeting the sea or ocean. So we cannot see such sandstone in a place where river have its origin. So with this, I end my video lecture. If you have any kind of query or difficulty in understanding, please don't forget to message in my WhatsApp group, or you can also put your comment at the comment box of the YouTube.